clear with addressing modes, then it is very, very easy to understand instruction set. Okay, today I will start instruction set. So if I will, and if you want me to start the class, just message me start. Okay, so we will see this thing. Okay, so today I am explaining about this instruction set of 8051. See, if you are familiar in modes of addressing modes of our 8051, then this class is very, very easy and very easy to understand. Okay. Okay. What is the need of instruction set? So it is explaining you how many number of instructions are available and what type of instructions are available and which instruction is used for our need. Okay. We need add instruction, add with carry instruction. We need increment. Okay, so you can increment the content of a register by adding one to that particular content of register, but also you can use increment operation. So in this fashion, so different things are available. You can do multiple additions. So by doing multiple additions also you can get multiplication, but you will waste some machine cycles. So in order to reduce the task, we are using multiply instruction. So different instructions are available. We will see how many instructions are available, what are the groups, and what is the importance of each instruction. Okay, first thing is, so I have already explained you that we have totally 111 instructions. They are divided into 5 groups, but in actual, what I can say, they are only 48 instructions. How, sir? So we have add with carry. They come under only one instruction, add. Okay, so in this fashion, totally, if you want to say, they are 111 instructions, but in actual sense, they are only total 48. So starting with arithmetic group of instructions, which is first one, you can see here, add a comma hash 25. So what is the meaning here, sir? If you are specifying hash in as a prefix to any number, this will act as data. Okay. Now one more thing to remember is, so the destination register in any arithmetic operation will be accumulator. You can't see any change here. So definitely the destination register is your accumulator. Now add a comma hash 25. So what will happen here? Okay, the contents available in a accumulator register and the contents, the content 25 will be added and the result will be stored in accumulator. Okay, now add a comma rx. What is rx specifying here? It is specifying RAM registers, or you can write here RR, okay, RX or RR, that will specify RAM registers. So we have seen R0 to R7, they are available in bank 0, bank 1, bank 2. Okay, in this fashion, they are what? RAM registers. Now what will happen with this instruction? You can add the content of any register with accumulator, result will be stored in A. Okay, third instruction is what? Add a comma 25. See here, nothing is available in front of a number, that will specify address. Now what will happen? The content which is available in the address 25, content available in address 25, that will be added to content of accumulator and the result will be stored in A. So to explain this thing clearly, I'm taking an example. If accumulator content is 10, okay, and the content available in the memory location whose address is 25, suppose that content is 25. Now with the help of this instruction, what is happening here? The content 5 will be added to 10. Okay, the result final, it will be once again stored in accumulator, that is 15. Okay, fourth instruction is what? Add a comma at the rate rp. So what is it? What is this? So this is what? Indirect addressing mode. Okay, so rp here, it is specifying register pointer. So we are using only two registers as the register pointers, R0 and R1. What is the reason? To decrease number of opcodes we are selecting, we are restricting ourselves for R0 and R1. Okay, what will happen here, sir? It is specifying at the rate, means what will happen? So the content here available in a memory location whose address is pointed out or whose address is available in RP register, that will be loaded into A. Or what you can read, see here, the contents available in the location pointed out by R0 will be added to A. See here, what is happening? The content available in R0 will be added to A and the result will be stored in A. So to clearly explain this thing, I have taken the example. See, if R0 equal to 20, okay, so this is acting as a address, okay, 20 address. So this is pointing to an memory location. It has a content as X. Now what is happening here? Add A comma at the rate R0, it means specifying that the content available in the memory location whose address is pointed out by R0 is added to accumulator and the result will be stored here. So the content is what? X. That content is added with accumulator and the result will be stored here in accumulator A. Now we have seen about add. Same thing we can see all these cases for add carry. Add carry. So simple question, sir. My question is, you have add, then why you are going for add with carry? Okay, the explanation is, see, if you require previous carry, if you are giving importance to previous carry, then okay, then you require add with carry. What is happening, sir, here? Add with carry A comma hash 25, then what will happen? Contents of accumulator plus this content 25 and the previously generated carry, will be added and the combined result will be stored in A. But what is the need, sir? When we need this add with carry, see here, I have taken the example. I'm adding 16 bit number 1, 2 and FF. So for this lower byte, I will use add instruction. So what is the numbers are here? 1, 2, FF, and I'm adding 0, 0, 0, 1 to this number. What will happen? F plus 1, it is what? 0 with carry 1. F plus 1 is what? 1, 0. So I'm writing 0 here, carry 1. Once again, F plus 1, it is what? 0 with carry 1, okay? Here, I can use add. See, if I'm using same add here, what will happen? 12 plus 0, 0, it will give 12. So the carry which is generated here is missing. So to give importance to consider this carry, I should use what? Add with carry instruction. That means if we are processor here in 8051, our processor is of 8 bit. So if you want to perform addition of 16 bits or 32 bits, then definitely you need to go with add with carry. Okay, I think this is very clear. Now coming to same things. So what we have discussed in add, the same thing will come here. Add with carry A comma R0. What will happen? A plus R0 content plus carry flag. Okay. Add C A comma 28. This is what? Address. Okay. The content available in 28 plus A plus definitely you need to consider carry flag. Once again, add with carry A comma the rate R0. What will happen, sir, here? Content of accumulator register plus content available in memory location pointed out by R0 plus carry flag. These things will be added and the result will be stored in A. Okay. Now we have subtract with borrow. We don't have subtract. Why, sir? So initially we are having triple one instructions. If you take subtract and subtract with borrow, the number of instructions will increase. To avoid that thing, simply I am going with subtract with borrow. So this thing is same. Subtract or subtract with borrow, both are same. Okay. What is the difference? Let us see subtract with borrow first. Subtract with borrow means subtract with borrow A comma hash 25. What will happen here? Contents available in A will be subtracted with 25 minus CF will be taken here. Okay. Minus CF will be taken here. The contents 25 as well as content in carry will be subtracted from the contents of accumulator. Okay. To understand better, I am using decimal number, not hexadecimal. Okay, not hexadecimal numbers, these are decimal numbers. 47 minus 21, 29, the answer is what? 18. So how is it possible, how you are getting this answer? See, 7 minus 9, which is not possible. So I am taking a borrow from 4, okay? It becomes 17, 17 minus 9, it becomes 8, okay? So 4 minus 1, because you have given one thing, or you can say 3 is available here. 3 minus 2, it becomes 1. So how this 1 has obtained? 4 was available. 4 minus 2 minus this borrow. Okay. So it becomes 1. So instead of writing borrow here, why I am writing carry? See, we have only carry flag to indicate K carry has occurred or not, and the same carry flag is used to store borrow has occurred or not. Okay, if we don't have separately borrow flag. Okay, one more thing, why we are not using separately subtract? If you want to do subtraction, you don't want to do subtract with borrow, you can use the same instruction. Simply what you need to do, I am using clear C, I am clearing carry. Carry flag is set to zero. That means if it is zero, minus zero, you won't consider this thing. It becomes, if you are clearing this carry flag with the instruction clear carry, CLR C, what happens? It becomes zero. So it becomes simple subtraction. Okay. Once again, the same conditions, same examples will be repeating here. Subtract with borrow A comma R naught. What will happen? Contents of R naught and carry flag will be subtracted from A. Result will be stored in A. Similarly here, subtract with borrow A comma 25. That means it is taken as address. So okay, what will happen? The contents available in this particular memory location pointed out by 25 will be subtracted from A, as well as carry flag will also be subtracted from A. The whole result will be stored in A. Similarly, subtract with borrow A comma the rate or not. What will happen, sir? Here, the content available in the memory location whose address is pointed out by R naught, this will be subtracted from A, as well as carry flag will also be subtracted. Whole result will be stored in A. Okay, so this carry flag is used for both carry as well as borrow. If you are performing addition operation, this carry, okay, this flag will carry carry bit. Okay, it is acting as carry bit. Okay, if you are performing subtract with borrow, the same carry flag will be indicating borrow. Okay. Now next instruction is increment. So what is the need of increment, sir? Where we see this increment instructions? Generally, when we are performing looping operations, when we are dealing with loops, okay, or we have seen in our Red 086 that when we are dealing with string operations, string related operations, we will set d equal to 0 for auto increment, d equal to 1 for auto decrement. Then if you have selected d equal to 0, we will perform increment operation. Likewise, we will also perform decrement operation. So we will see what is, how we are using this increment operation. If I am writing increment A, what will happen? The contents of A will be incremented by 1. The result will be stored in A. Similarly, A increment R naught, content will be incremented, stored in R naught. Increment 25, see what is happening here. So this 25, no prefix is available. That means this is acting as address. Okay, the content available in address will be incremented. That content will be incremented and it will be once again loaded in the same memory location. Okay, content available in the memory location 25. Consider the example 25, it is having some X. If you are performing this instruction increment 25, what will happen, sir? This X will be incremented by 1 and the result will be stored once again in the same memory location. Increment at the rate R naught. Okay, so if you are clear with one instruction, then everything is clear. Content available in the memory location pointed out by R naught will get incremented and it will be stored in the same memory location. Okay, this is interesting. Okay, increment DPTR. So first thing is, what DPTR is? What a 16 bit register available in our 8051. So 16 bit, our processor is of what? In 8051 we have 8 bit processor. To deal with 16 bit, we need two machine cycles. Okay, one machine cycle for half byte or lower byte, and for higher byte you need second machine cycle. Okay, so the content available in the register will be incremented by 1. Once again it will be stored in DPTR itself. Okay, now coming to decrement, you have seen here 5 increment instructions are available, but here you can see only 4 decrement instructions are available. Why? I will explain the reason. Similarly, same thing will happen here, same thing will continue. Instead of increment, decrement. That means minus. Instead of A plus 1, you need to write A minus 1. Okay, why there is no decrement, sir? Decrement DPTR is not available. Why? See, I have mentioned that we are having 111 instructions. If you take decrement DPTR, once again it becomes increasing the total number of instructions. And one more reason, one more peculiar reason is that, so here when you're dealing with 16 bit register, you require 2 machine cycles. So to perform decrement operation, we are using 2 machine cycles. To avoid that thing, simply what I will do, sir, you have DPTR means you are having a higher byte as well as lower byte. consider the example, please. I think everyone is having pen and paper. Please, you write 2014, 2014, please. Listen to this example. If it is by audio, it is good, that is okay. Otherwise, you people write here 2014, okay? 14 is in lower byte, 20 is in upper byte. If I want to decrement this, okay, decrement the content pointed out by this address. So what I will do, sir, 2014, if I want to decrease this 2014, I will select lower byte, that is DPTR L. If I want to select higher byte, DPTR H, okay? I want to decrement 14, 20 will remain constant, okay? 20 will remain constant. So what is happening, see here, 14 I can decrement, only I will select DPTR L, and if I will perform decrement operation, okay? Or I can perform subtraction operation, subtract by 1. So what will happen, sir? Only that particular byte will be selected and it will get decremented by 1. Similarly, you can perform sub using the help of subtraction operation, you can perform the same thing. So for that reason, we are not using decrement DPTR, because for this thing we require 2 machine cycles, okay? And coming to this important thing, multiplication operation. So here you can see the syntax, mul AB, no comma is available here, mul AB. So what will happen? One operand will be stored in A, the second number will be stored in B, you will perform the multiplication operation. And the result will be stored in A, the lower byte of the result will be stored in A, and the higher byte will be stored in B, okay? So why we are selecting this lower byte, sir? For accumulator, you can give higher byte or lower byte, but most of the cases, suppose you are multiplying 02 with 04, you will get the answer as 08, which is a 8-bit number. So you can store the result in accumulator itself. Suppose you are multiplying FF with FF, okay? Then you will get a large number, okay? Large number. Then you need to store that extra bits, you need this B register, okay? Similarly, divide operation, divide A comma B, okay? Once again, no is available here, divide A B. So what is happening here? A content divide B content. That is divide 22 by 2. You will get what 11 will be stored in A, and what the content of B, it will be 0. You can take any example. But the special example is that if the content of B is 0, what will happen, sir? Will it enter into infinite loop? No. So before performing that operation, the processor will indicate that you have taken a wrong content in B, overflow will be generated. So the result will appear and it will generate an overflow saying that your contents are wrong, please verify the contents, okay? Next thing. Now, decimal adjust accumulator, very important instruction, okay? And already you have learned this thing in your 8086, okay? So what are the, in this you have 4 possibilities, 4 cases are available when this DAA is used, decimal adjust after addition. That means this is very, very clear that this instruction is needed only after performing addition, okay? You need to do some adjustments after addition. So first you will perform addition, then you will do this adjustments, okay? Here 4 cases are available. If the lower nibble, okay, after getting the result, after performing addition, you will verify. If the lower nibble is greater than 9, this is going to be your case 1. You have generated an auxiliary carry, this is going to be your case 2. So what you will do, sir, if this case occurs, then what you will do? You will add 06 here. In this case 1 and 2, what you will do? You will add 06 here, okay? To do the adjustment, okay? You are doing the adjustment, okay? Why you need only 6, sir? The answer is very, very clear. The decimal numbers are from 0 to 9. Hexadecimal numbers are from 0 to F. That is, after 9, how many numbers are available? 6 numbers are available. What are those 6 number? Instead of numbers, you can say they are characters. What are those? A, B, C, D, E, and F. So to come out of these hexadecimal characters, once again, I'm adding 6, okay? What are the other cases? Higher nibble may be greater than 9. That comes under case 3. Or you have generated a carry in your addition. So that is what case 4. So what you will do, sir, what is the adjustment you have to do here? The adjustment is that you need to add 60 here, okay? Simple. If lower nibble is having some error. If lower nibble is not in decimal, so you need to add 6 here to bring into decimal form. If higher nibble is not a valid decimal, you need to add 6 to this higher nibble. That means what you are adding to lower nibble? 0. So I am specifying you need to add 6, 0 for case 3 and case 4. Okay, case 3 and case 4, you need to add 6, 0. And for case 1 and 2, you need to add 0, 6. So I will take the examples here. Okay, I am taking the examples. Okay, for this examples, I need to switch on the camera. I need to explain. Okay. Okay, otherwise, even though I can explain this thing, this is very, very simple. See, sir, just you add, so here, what are the examples I have taken? All the examples in terms of hexadecimal numbers. Just you take 25, okay, decimal numbers. If you just simply add 25 rupees to 25 rupees in decimal, we are dealing with decimal. So what will be your answer? 25 plus 25, it will be 50. But if you take the same numbers in hexadecimal form, 25H and 25H. Okay. If you add these things, what will be your answer? Come on, add these things. 5 plus 5 is what? 10. How you represent 10 in hexadecimal? 0 to 9 and then 10 is represented as A. Okay. How the 10 is represented? 10 is represented as A. Okay. And 2 plus 2 is 4. So here you are getting what? 4A. You are in decimal, if you add 25 plus 25, directly you will get answer 50. But in hexadecimal, if you are adding this, you are getting 4A. So what is happening? So practical, in practical application, so in supermarkets, you see cash counters, at the cash counters, they will be typing this numbers. Okay, if you have taken two quantities of 25 rupees each, so simply he will add 25 and he will add 25. That will be given to a computer. So internally it is, the processor will understand, it will take in terms of binary. So it will do the calculations in terms of binary, but you have in practical world, you are using decimal. So simple 25 plus 25, you will understand as 50, but processor won't understand as 50. It will, so the inputs given as in a program, they are given as hexadecimal. So there is a difference, okay? You are getting 4A instead of 50. So you need to do some adjustments to bring back to original form, to bring back to decimal form. So what I will do? So I will see this condition is falling in which case. So lower nibble is what? Greater than 9. Okay, it is what? Case 1. So what the adjustment I need to do? I need to add 06 to this number. So 06 means A. If you are adding 6 to A, what will happen, sir? Come on, add 6 things. Okay, A means after A you have B, C, D, E, F and plus 1. F plus 1 is what? 10. 10 means what is happening, see here. So it becomes 0 and 1 will be given as carry here. So 4 plus 1, it becomes what? 50. It is very clear. So otherwise you can write in binary form all 00, 10 and 0101. In this fashion also you can get the answer very clearly, but you will get lower nibble as higher than 9. So you need to add 06 here. This is what case 1. Coming to second thing, case 2. What is case 2? Auxiliary carry. You add 28 plus 28. What will happen, sir? You convert this thing in binary, then you can clearly understand. But if I am going to convert all these numbers into binary and then going to explain you, it becomes complex and time will be more. So to avoid that thing, I am directly adding this in hexa. See here, how you are adding in hexa. Okay, 8. If you are adding plus 1, 8 plus 1, it becomes 9. 9 plus 1, it becomes A. So I am adding, see here, count, listen to this. If I am adding 8 extra numbers, what will happen? 8. Okay, original number is 8. Then if you are adding 1, 9, instead of 10, A, then B, C, D, E, F. Then what comes? F plus 1 is what? 10. Okay, 10. So here, the result is what? 10. I'm adding 0 here, I'm placing 0 here and taking the carry here. So it becomes what? 2 plus 2, it is 2 plus 2 plus 1, it means 5. Here it is 50. Okay, but actually you need to get 56. So here it is if here the condition is what, upper nibble and lower nibble both are lesser than 9, but you have generated auxiliary carry, so for that you need to add 06. After adding 06, you will get 56, which is equivalent to your decimal addition. Okay, then case 3 is what, higher nibble is greater than 1, so add 50 plus 50. Okay, 0 plus 0 is 0, 5 plus 5 is what, 10 a, so this a is what, greater than 9. So to do the correction, what I will do, I will add 60. Okay, so what is the answer here, sir? If you are adding these things, a plus 6 means b, c, d, e, f, and f plus 1 is 10. So z, I will take 0 here, I will write 0 here and 1. So the answer is what, 100. But how this is stored, you need to understand this thing. So this two, this thing 00 will be stored in your accumulator and 1 will be stored in carry. Okay, so the whole thing what you can read, this is what, 100. I think it is very very clear. Result 00 will be stored in accumulator, carry flag will be holding 1, so the combined thing is what, 100. Okay, now coming to fourth case. What is fourth case, sir? Here carry, if carry is generated, then you need to add 60. So in this case 3 and case 4, you are going to add 60 to the number, to the result. And if you have obtained this case 1 and 2, you will be adding 06 to the result. Here consider the case 4, okay, 80 plus 80. So what should be the answer in decimal? Definitely it should be 160. But if you add here 0 plus 0 is 0 and 8 plus 8, once again 9, a, b, c, d, e, f, after f what you will get, 10. So 8 numbers, so 10, it is 0 and carry is what, 1. Okay, now these two things, upper nibble and lower nibble, both are lesser than 9, but you have generated carry here, so this comes under what, case 4. So what you need to do in case 4, you need to add 60 here. I'm adding 60 here. 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 6 is 6, and 1 is available in carry. So total result is what, 160, but 60 is available in accumulator, carry flag will be holding 1. Okay, this is the condition. Okay, now a special case. Okay, in this special case, you can see here, combined case or special case, suppose you have generated auxiliary carry as well as carry. Okay, or what may be the condition, if lower nibble may be greater than 9 or higher nibble may be greater than 9. So anything may occur, combined cases. So combination of this, any four cases may take place. I am taking this case, auxiliary carry has generated as well as carry has generated. In this case, then what you need to do, first you need to add 06 and then you need to add 60. Okay, I will take this example, 99H plus 99H. Okay, add this thing in decimal, 99 rupees plus 99, it becomes 198 rupees. That is in decimal. But coming to hexadecimal, what is happening? See, 9 plus 9, it is generating 12. How? See, sir, 9. After that, what is the number? 10. 10 is what? A. So I am adding all these things in hexadecimal. Okay, 9 plus A, B, C, D, E, F. After F, what you will get? 10, 12. Okay, you are getting what? 12. Okay, the answer is what? 12. So here 12 means you are adding, you are placing 2 here and carry will be 1. Okay, now you are adding 9 plus 10, it becomes 13, 13. So 3 is available here, 1 will be given as carry. See here, upper nibble and lower nibble both are lesser than 9, but you have generated carry. You have generated carry as well as auxiliary carry. So what is the auxiliary carry? It is what? It comes under case 2. Case 2 means what? You need to add 06. First of all, I will add 06. So 2 plus 6, it will be 8. 3 plus 0, it is 3. Carry is available here. So because you have generated carry, what I need to do? I need to add 60. I will add 60. Then what it becomes? 8 plus 0, it is 8. 3 plus 6, it is 9. 1 is available, that is taken in carry. So the answer is 198, which is matching with your decimal number. Okay. So how the result will be available? 98 will be available in accumulator. 1 will be available in carry flag. I think it is very clear. See, please do this thing as your homework. Okay, you take this 25 in binary and you add, you will get the same numbers, but you will get some clarity. Okay, if it is case 1, add 06, then you can do all these things. But my sincere suggestion is that you convert all these numbers, okay, take these cases and convert them into binary and add, you will get a very clear idea about this thing. Okay. Now coming to next group of instructions, that is one logical group of instructions. So what is the need of this logical group of instructions? Here you can perform different logics. What are the different logics? AND gate. Okay, you can design gates. Simply to say, you can design gates, AND gate, OR gate, and NOT gate. So from these gates, we can generate NAND, NOR, and other available gates. So let us see the logics here. So let us see the instruction. ANL. Okay, the syntax is what? ANL A comma hash 25. Second operand. Okay, ANL means AND logically, logical AND. Okay, simply you can read as logical AND A comma hash 25. Hash 25 means it is what? Data. Okay, it is considered as data. What will happen, sir? You will perform AND operation. Suppose it is having internally A is having 10. 10, you will perform AND operation with 25 and the result will be stored in A. A AND with 25, result will be stored in A. Similarly, ANL A comma R naught, what will happen? Contents of A will be ANDed with contents of R naught, result will be stored in A. Similarly, A comma simple 25, not hash, nothing is available here. That means, so this 25 is an address pointing to some location. So what will happen, sir? The content available in this 25 will be ANDed and the result will be stored in A. Similarly, indirect addressing mode R naught. So the content available in a memory location whose address is pointed out by R naught, that content will be ANDed with contents of A and the result will be stored in A. Okay. Now the facility which was not available in your previous instruction, what were the previous instructions? Mathematic instructions, their destination register must be accumulator itself. No other possibility. But here you have the facility that you can change the destination register. Okay. Now what is the instruction? AND logically 25 comma A. What will happen, sir, here? The contents available in A will be ANDed with contents available in a memory location whose address is 25 and the result will be stored in the same memory location. Okay. Next thing. AND logical AND 25 comma hash 25. So this is interesting. So this 25 is indicating what address and this 25 is your data. So this 25 data will be ANDed with some content available in in a memory location pointed by address 25. So some content is available. That content will be ANDed with 25 number. Result will be once again stored in the same memory location whose address is what? 25. Okay, same thing, whatever you have seen in AND logic, same will come here for OR logic. So logical OR, ORL stands for what? Logical OR A comma R naught. Simple. Okay, you need, what will happen in AND and OR? OR, if any of the input is 1, the result will be 1. If any of the input, okay, simple thing, if any of the input is 1, the result will be 1. But how you are going to use this OR logic in our programming? Suppose I am taking the example here. See, I have a number A. Okay, in this A, I have a number 35, 0011 and 0101. So this is what 35. Now the task is that I want to change, okay, set lower nibble without affecting higher nibble. Then what I will do, sir? Simply, I will add here what? 0F. What is 0F, sir? 0 means all are 0. F means all are 1s. What will happen? I am performing and I will write ORL A comma, I can directly write in this, in the place of 25, I can write ORL A comma 0F, okay, hash, sorry, I need to use hash because it is acting as data. So I will use this instruction, sorry. I can use any of this thing, okay, simply the content should be 0F, okay, ORL A comma hash 0F. What will happen? 0F means here 1, because of 1, anything plus 1, definitely the answer will be 1. Okay, this lower number will be set, and anything plus 0, that answer will be anything for OR gate. So upper byte or higher byte is not affected, lower byte is set. So we are using OR to set any content. Similarly, we have seen about AND. What is the truth table, sir? If one input is 0, the result is 0. So we are using this AND gate to clear the contents. Okay, if I same example 35, if I want to clear the contents of lower nibble without affecting higher nibble, what I will do is an AND A comma hash F0. So this is F, this won't get affected, same thing will come, and here it is 0, so everything will become 0. Okay, so some explanation is available, but if you are interested you can message me, I will explain this thing. Okay, now coming to next instruction, that is what XOR. Okay, logical XOR, simple. Once again the examples remain same thing. I have continued with 25 here, I will write the same thing, but see the truth table. What is the purpose of this XOR? So if you see the truth table you will understand XOR. Okay, what is the logic here, sir? If both inputs are same, result is 0. See here, both inputs are same, the result is 0. So otherwise I can understand in this fashion also. Okay, if one input is 0, okay, here you see, if the one input is 0, so what is the other input? The result will be the same thing. So 0 XOR with anything, answer is anything. Once again, see here, 0 XOR with anything, answer is anything. Okay, now coming to 1, if one input is 1, the result is complement of anything. So here it is what, 1 XOR with 0, answer is what, complement of this thing. Here once again 1 XOR with 1, answer is what, complement of this one. So using this logic, if I want to complement anything, complement lower nibble or higher nibble, I can do that thing. So I am taking the example here, once again 35. If I want to complement lower nibble without affecting higher nibble, what I will do is a simple thing. I will take 0f and I will perform XOR XRL A comma hash 0f. What will happen, sir? Here you can see here, if one input is 1, the other content will be complemented. See, here it is 1, the other thing will be complemented. So it becomes what? 1010. If one input is 0, answer is the next input. Next, whatever the input is available here, the same thing will be repeating here. So what are the applications of AND logic here? To complement, sorry, the application of XOR logic is what? To complement any lower byte or higher byte, it's up to us. Or we can complement both bytes also. Okay, and what is the application of your OR? To set any byte, upper byte or lower byte, or you can set complete byte by setting giving FF. And what is the application of AND logic? So to clear any nibble, upper nibble or lower nibble, based on your requirement. Okay, now coming to rotate instructions. So this is a very simple and very easy instruction, already you have seen in 8086. So what will happen, sir? Rotate left, RL comma A is your syntax. What will happen if I'm performing this rotate left? So LSB, from LSB it is going to next bit, and MSB content will be loaded into carry flag, as well as the MSB bit comes in place of LSB. See, MSB is moved to two locations. First location is what, carry flag position, and the second position is what, LSB position. Similarly, rotate right A, what is happening, sir? Rotate right, LSB will be moved into carry, as well as it will go to MSB. One thing, sir, so what is the application of this rotate instruction, sir? So already in 8086 we have seen, if I want to know, we have seen many programs, if I want to know, okay, consider rotate left application. If I want to know whether this number is positive or negative, so in 7 bits, what will happen? MSB, if it is 0, it is indicating, if you perform rotate left, so here it will be 0. If carry is 0 means this particular number is one positive number. If MSB is 1, if you perform rotate left, carry will be set. So that indicates that this particular number is what? Negative number. Similarly, we have written a program regarding this. Okay. Sorry. Similarly, rotate right operation. What is the application here, sir? Rotate right. If I want to know, a number is given here. If I want to know whether this number is odd or even, so if 0 is available here, okay, so if I'm performing rotate right one time, what will happen? Carry will be set. Sorry, if it is 0, carry will be 0. So it is indicating that this particular number is what? An even number. Okay, If it is an odd number, what will happen, sir? Here one will be available. Okay. If one is available, if I perform rotate right, what will happen? Carry flag will set. It is in, and it is indicating that this particular number is an odd number. To know positive or negative, you will use rotate left logic. Okay. To know number is odd or even, you will use rotate right logic or rotate right operation instruction. Clear? And one more thing, to swap lower bytes and higher bytes, what will happen, sir? If I perform rotate left operation 4 times, what will happen, sir? So this MSB is replaced with, MSB is placed in place of LSB. See, in this fashion, a lower nibble will come in position of higher nibble, and higher nibble will come in place of lower nibble. If you perform the same thing 4 times, rotate right, what will happen? You can exchange lower byte with higher byte. And one more thing, rotate left, they are useful in these things are useful in our 8085 because we don't have multiply and divide instructions. So what is happening, see here, if accumulator content is 3, I am performing rotate left. Rotate left means bits will shift in the left hand side. Okay, so what happens, one comes here, this one comes here, 0 comes here, and the MSB 0 comes in position of LSB. So what has happened, sir? Initially it was 3, now it is what, 6. That means it, you have performed multiplying by 2. This operation is what, multiplying operation. Okay, using these instructions you can multiply the contents of accumulator with 2. Okay, once again the same content, 0 double 1, it is 6. If you perform rotate left here, what happens, this bit shift in the left hand side, it becomes 12. So in left hand, rotate left is what, multiplying by 2, and similarly rotate right means divide by multiplying. For that you will be using rotate left instruction, and for dividing you will be using rotate right instruction. You can see, you can take example 12 and you can do rotate right, it becomes 6, and once again if you perform, it becomes 3. Okay, coming to boolean instructions. Okay, coming to boolean instructions, what is happening, sir? Coming to boolean instructions, these are also called bit instructions. Okay, boolean instructions or bit instructions. So if I want to clear a particular bit, or if I want to set a particular bit, I can use what, these instructions. So first instruction is what, carry flag. Okay, if I want to set the carry flag, I can use the instruction set B C. So what will happen, carry flag will be set to 1. Similarly, CLR C, clear carry, so carry flag will be 0. If I want to complement, I can use the instruction CPL C, complement C. So what then will happen, sir? The initially whatever may be available, that will be complemented, and once again it will be stored in carry flag. Okay, now to complement any bit, I am using B as a bit, any bit. Okay, so for that I have examples here. Set B comma a particular bit of a register. Okay, this B is indicating a bit of a particular register. So what is happening, sir? Set B PSW 0.3, in place of B I am using what, PSW 0.3. then what will happen, sir? We have seen PSW register, program status board register, third bit PSW.3, this particular bit will be set. Similarly, set B P0.3, port 0, third bit will be set. Okay, set B 25. So what is this 25, sir? So this 25 is bit addressable address. So in internal RAM structure, you have seen 20 to 2F, those contents, okay, those memory locations, 20 to 2F memory locations can be used as bit addressable. Okay, that area we have named as what, bit addressable area. We have seen this thing in our internal architecture, internal RAM structure. So 20 to 2F locations are for what, bit addressable. Okay, so that address is 25, so that particular address content will be set. Okay, similarly you can do these things, CLR PSW 0.3 or anything, so complement. Okay, you can perform complement also. Okay, but you need to remember one thing. Okay, so to change the content of a particular bit, you can use these instructions. Okay, Now coming to move instructions. So these move instructions are for what? For bit, for a particular bit. You are moving a content into a particular bit. That previously what we have seen, move instruction, move a comma hash 25. So that means you are loading some content into complete register, not in a particular bit. But here you are loading some content in a particular bit. Okay, move c comma b. So what will happen? Content this particular bit b, it may be 0 or 1, that will be given into c. Okay, move c. What is c, sir? C is what? Nothing but it is your carry flag. Move c p 0.3. if p 0.3 is having 1, it will be set carry flag. If it is 0, it will reset carry flag. Okay, move b comma c is also possible. Content available c will be given into b. So move p 0.4 comma c, what will happen? C, if it is 0, 0 will be given to p 0.5. you need to remember one thing, why we are using this c. Means c here, this c is your carry flag. So it is acting as accumulator in bit operations. In byte operations we have accumulator register a, that is acting as accumulator. But here c, for bit operations, this c is acting as accumulator. Remember only one thing, c is acting as accumulator for bit operations. Okay, in bit instructions. Now if I want to design AND gate using logical AND, okay, ANL is for logical AND. C comma B, what will happen? C is ANDed with B and the result will be stored in A. See here, our C is acting as accumulator. Okay, so what will happen, sir? C and B will be given as input to AND, the result once again it will be stored in C. AND logic C comma slash B. Slash B means B bar. So we can't write B bar. Okay, so to get that thing we are using slash B. That means what will happen? The contents of C will be ANDed with B bar content and they are stored in what? C. So here design part, if you see, the inputs of this AND gate are C and B. To generate B bar we are using inverter here, that is NOT gate. Okay, once again the result will be stored in C. Okay, OR logic, what will happen? You are performing OR logical, OR of C and B. Once again the result will be stored in C. C OR B and result will be stored in C. Similarly you can understand these things, they are very very clear. Okay, so this it is extra bit. Okay, it becomes complex if I explain these things. Okay, no need to learn these things. So this will be available if students are interested to know. If I am giving a, so consider this as an assignment. If interested students, they can write simulate, means write a program. Okay, write a program to read the contents of this G, whatever may be the contents of A, B. What these things can hold? They can hold 0 or 1, B may be 0 or 1, C may be 0 or 1. So to get the value of G, you can write a program. It's up to you. If you are interested, you can ask me. I will explain how to write a program for this, but for now it is not necessary. Okay, so this is how you can write a program. Okay, okay. With this today's class end. If you have any